Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Thank you. reading from the book of Proverbs. Put not forth thyself in the presence of the king, and stand not in the place of great men. For better it is that it is said unto thee, come up hither, than that thou shouldest be put lower in the presence of the prince whom thine eyes have seen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Hebrews. Let brotherly love continue. Be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. Remember them that are in bonds as bound with them, and them which suffer adversity as being yourselves also in the body. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers judge. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I shall not fear what man shall do unto me. Remember them which have the rule over you, who have spoken unto you the word of God, whose faith follow. considering the end of the conversation. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. But to do good and to communicate, forget not. For with such sacrifices, God is well pleased. The word of the Lord.
According to Saint Luke. And it came to pass, as he went into the house of one of the chief Pharisees to eat bread on the Sabbath day, that they watched him. And he put forth a parable to those who were bidden, when he marked how they chose out the chief rooms, saying unto them, when thou art hidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him. And he that bade thee and him come and say to thee, give this man place, and thou begin with shame to take the lowest room. But when thou art bidden, go and sit down in the lowest room, that when he that bade thee cometh, he may say unto thee, friend, go up higher. Then shalt thou have worship in the presence of them that sit at meat with thee. For whosoever exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted. Then said he also to him that bade him, when thou makest a dinner or a supper, call not thy friends, nor thy brethren, neither thy kinsmen, nor thy rich neighbors, lest they also bid thee again, and a recompense be made thee. But when thou makest a feast, call the poor, the maimed, the lame, the blind, and thou shalt be blessed, for they cannot recompense thee, for thou shalt be recompensed at the resurrection of the just. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Christ.
Thank you.
Amen. Please be seated. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Welcome to St. John the Evangelist. If this is your first time here, well, we hope you make it more times here. If you're visiting, we hope you are treated well and find this to be a place where you are in the presence of God and people who love you and each other very much. Speaking of loving each other and how we care for each other, one thing that I've learned about Newport is you have a lot of dinner parties. And you get out all the things, right? The candles that smell good, the lights, the special plates, your plates all match, right? All the nice things to celebrate your guests, and everything is done just beautifully. We invite people who we know, people we like. You'll hear people whisper, you should invite them, you know who they are. There's a lot of that around Newport, isn't there? Well, Jesus is kind of going to talk to us a little bit about that today. Hospitality is really important. And as much effort and time as you put into hospitality and welcoming our guests and making sure everything's perfect, in the ancient times, hospitality was even more. Hospitality meant more than a nice smelling bathroom with a fancy candle in it. Hospitality meant that somebody was safe in your home, that you were protecting them, and they would come and you would feed them, you would clothe them, you would care for them, and they were safe. And in exchange, they would tell you stories about them and their lives and their hopes and dreams. And then, somewhere down the line, you would be the guest in their house. And the same would be said for your visit. We see an example of this actually in the Old Testament when Abraham was sleeping under the tree and he saw the three men in front of him, and his scripture says he jumped up and he said, "What do you need?" And he began to get them water and care and ran home and said to Sarah, "Sarah, bake a cake." Bake a cake. God endorses eating of cake. You heard it here first. And she makes the cake, and they sit down to eat, and the men say, "You are going to have a son." And you know the story, seriously. It's impossible. I can't have a son. I'm too old to have a son. And Abraham's going, "Oh, maybe." And then all of a sudden, she's pregnant with the baby, and here comes Isaac. Hospitality. It really matters. And so then we move on in the gospel reading, and Jesus has explained to us, the King James Version makes this really hard this morning, by the way. If you got it, good for you, because I didn't get it. So I'm glad you got it. But once we get further into the reading, we hear about what it is that really matters. And at the end of the day, what Jesus is telling them, it doesn't matter who sits here or who sits there. It's the relationship with each other. And never think that the person that you think is the least is the least, because they're probably the most important. And then he kind of goes into this thing about the last shall be first, right? And he says, when you have a feast, he says, don't invite your family, don't invite your friends, don't invite the rich neighbors. Invite the broken. Invite the poor. Invite those who are broken in body and broken in spirit. Because they're the ones who cannot do anything for you. And then you'll receive your blessing. Can I just tell you this morning that this is like the Jesus way of doing things? That it's all the things that make sense, all the things that seem normal, all the things that seem to be what God wants us to be, that we think it is, it's always backwards. We think we have to find all the right people. We got to find all the right things. And God says, no, find the broken. You want to find me? Find the lost. You want to find me? Find the one that you think is least deserving of my love, and there will I be. That is where Jesus is.
And so as a church, as a body of Christ, may this place always be one of hospitality. Not just hospitality, but radical hospitality, where you can come in and we will keep you safe. We will care for you. We will love you. We will provide for you. No matter who you are, what your address is, and what your zip code is, you are welcome at this place. If you can't say amen to that, you better see me for confession. This is what Jesus has called us to. No one is suggesting that at Thanksgiving you don't invite your family. Although you could use the scripture if you wanted to at Thanksgiving. Sorry, I can't invite you this year. No one's saying that family gatherings are bad, or having friends over are bad, or looking at who's in your community and being in communication and network with them is bad. But don't ever forget, wherever walk over or step by, the one who is broken that we think is less than or struggles more, because you may actually be walking next to somebody that God has sent to give you an opportunity for blessing. That's where God's blessing is. Who God sends us is the least is the greatest. That, my friends, is what Christianity is. That is what discipleship is. So look around you. Look around you. I know this on purpose. Look around you. The least amongst us is the greatest. The broken is the greatest. The one who struggles is the greatest. The one who is sick is the greatest. That is where God wants to allow the Holy Spirit to change us to be the hands and feet of Jesus in the world around us. So when we plan our meals, and we're going to be planning some stuff coming up, big dinners, am I going to invite the mayor? Yep. But guess what? Anybody and everybody is welcome and will be treated as the greatest. And their place may surprise you when we all get to heaven. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
is offered to the greater glory of God. And in thanksgiving for the glorious resurrection and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in thanksgiving for the gift of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, and in thanksgiving for all the blessings of this life, including those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or aloud. For those celebrating birthdays this week, especially Derek, John, Ruth, Mia, James, Anne, James, Joseph, Thomas, and Abigail, and all those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or aloud. For all those celebrating anniversaries this week, especially Tom and Amy, we offer thanksgivings, silently or aloud. We remember those for whom our prayers have been asked, especially those on the parish prayer list, for all those affected by the coronavirus pandemic, and for all those for whom we pray now, silently or aloud. Among them we remember Liz, Patrick, Richard, Ron, Rita, and for all those for whom we pray. Pray for the repose of the souls of the departed, especially Stephen, Crawford, Sumner, John, Marion, and Louise, and for all those we remember now, silently or aloud, for the departed members of the Guild of All Souls, for the departed sisters and associates of the Holy Nativity, for all those who have died in the war in Ukraine, and for those who have been victims of violence in our own country. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Father, we pray for thy holy Catholic Church. Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world. Give us grace to do thy will in all that we undertake. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. Give to the departed eternal rest. We praise thee for thy saints who have entered into joy. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Accept the fervent prayers of thy people. In the multitude of thy mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to thee for help. For thou art gracious, O lover of souls, and to thee we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Ye who truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, follow the commandments of God, and walk from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly yield. Almighty God, Father,
Lord of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, good of all men, we acknowledge you as our manifold sin.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Peace, everyone. Welcome to St. John's. Please be seated. There's about 38 minutes of announcements. Here we go. Just kidding.
Just kidding.
So, as I said before, if this is your first time at St. John's, we are glad you're here. We welcome you. We invite you to stick around. If you have not received a guest card, when the ushers come by, just ask them for one, and they'll bring you a guest card. And what happens when you fill out the guest card? Well, the guest card is good for one cup of coffee at Dunkin' Donuts, where you and I can get to know each other and chat and talk, and we can spend some time together. So fill that out so I can follow up and get to know you. And other announcements, so tomorrow at 8:30 is morning prayer, 5:30 is evening prayer. Tuesday at 6 o'clock will be our last Music on the Lawn for the season. So hopefully it don't get rained out. I know it's still calling for rain, but maybe it'll not. So come join us on Tuesday at 6 for the last Music on the Lawn for the season. And then Wednesday at 6 o'clock, Mass, where we will remember Aiden and Cuthbert. They sound like Hollywood critics, but they're actually saints of the church. They're bishops. So come on Tuesday night as we remember them, or Wednesday, I'm sorry, Wednesday night as we remember them at 6, followed by everybody's favorite thing, will be a finance committee meeting at the Guild Hall. So we got lots going on. And then Thursday, just morning prayer at 8:30, evening prayer at 5:30, Friday, just rest with Jesus and get ready for Sunday. Mass at 8 o'clock and High Mass at 10 o'clock. Also, a couple other things I just wanted to mention briefly. October 1st is our fall festival. We're planning a festival. Boy, that made a lot of sense. We're planning a festival on October 1st for the October 1st fall festival. John Ward is planning that and helping us get that together. So if you are interested in participating in any way, see John Ward or see one of the vestry members, and we can help you get on the schedule. And I think we've got a table set up, different events, so it should be a beautiful time on October 1st. Then also, if you have not received a copy of the e-news in your email box, let me know so we can add your email. Why? Because there's a wonderful video that was sent out this week regarding the choir school and all the things they did while in Connecticut a couple weeks ago. So is there another way to get that, Peter? Is there like a link on our YouTube page or Facebook? If you want the link to the video, just let us know. We'll get it posted on YouTube also, so you'll be able to see it on our YouTube channel. So it was a wonderful week of fun and learning, and we thank all the folks that were involved in putting it up, setting it up, especially Peter and Jen, the whole Burton family, and of course all of the kids that were and enjoyed it. Lastly, is when you're still looking for acolytes, altar guild, and flower guild. You don't have to do all three, but if you could do one or half of it, that would be great. So what is it? Altar guild? You get to help with all the beautiful things. There's a lot of setting up that takes place. You know, we have seasonal colors in the liturgy, so we change the frontal, we change this, we change all of the things get changed. And it doesn't take long if you have enough people doing it. It literally will take less than half an hour. Making sure that the linens are clean and that everything, it's just the careful, caring act. Flower guild, it really is what it sounds like. It's flowers. Flowers are pretty. We like flowers in church. Right now, our flower guild, altar guild, and acolyte is Bill Therry. Bill, let everybody take a look at you and thank you for being our acolyte, flower guild, and altar guild. So every Friday, Bill takes care of all three, and I know you're welcome to support and help. So if you're interested in any of that, please let me know, and we will. That might get you a free cup of coffee at Dunkin'. So I don't know what we're talking about. I think that's all I have for announcements. So, walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
Sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and be in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Christ our Passover is sacred.
You do not presume to come to this table. Trust in our righteousness, and in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much to gather around the table, but thou art the same Lord which is far to be with all his majesty. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so that we may be flesh and bear your Son Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, and us into the body of the name of me by his body, and our soul.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Happy are we who are clothed in the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank
you that thou hast vouchsafed to lead us,
who have duly received these holy mysteries
with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of thy favor and witness towards us, and that we are very members of the corporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is a blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs to the hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by thy merits in his most precious death and passion. And we come to beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, and that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost, we owe honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.